Hi everyone, I'm Julian, an AV Foundation engineer. In recent years, we've introduced HLS Interstitials as a simple way to insert ads into your main content. This year, we are offering new ways to present and navigate with Interstitials. So if you're interested in including ads, or just want to learn how to incorporate HLS Interstitials in new ways, you tuned into the right session. In this talk, we'll start with a recap of how HLS Interstitial works today. We'll follow this with discussing our new integrated timeline API, which provides a data model for building your app's UI experience. Lastly, we'll discuss what's new with Interstitial SharePlay. Let's quickly review HLS Interstitials. With HLS Interstitials, ads or interstitials are separate assets that can be scheduled on the main content timeline. This is your typical media playlist. We want to schedule an interstitial at 5 seconds into the content. We simply specify the start date as 5 seconds from the content's program date time. The content will then play primary content up until 5, and then start playing the interstitial URL. Finally, we resume playback of primary content after the interstitial completes. HLS Interstitials provides many benefits in comparison to direct insertion of ads into the main content. Interstitials allows for late-binding ad decisioning and does not require ads to be conditioned with the primary content. While HLS Interstitials has primarily been used for ad insertion, we like to encourage its usage for presenting other auxiliary content, such as show promos, studio banners, and program recap segments as a drop-in replacement to content served as discontinuities. This is scratching the surface of inserting HLS Interstitials in your content. If you'd like to learn more, please check out Explore Dynamic Pre-rolls and Mid-rolls in HLS. This year, we're offering a new AV Foundation API called Integrated Timeline. This API introduces a data model for timing and sequence of playback of content with interstitials. You'll be able to utilize this data model to build new UI experiences and enable your user to seamlessly navigate in and out of interstitials. We'll start off with an overview of different ways interstitials can be presented on the integrated timeline. Afterwards, we'll move on to understanding the API and how you can use it. We will then take a look at an example app using integrated timeline for building its UI. Lastly, we'll discuss new HLS syntax for describing how an interstitial should behave in the integrated timeline. Let's jump in and look at some of the ways interstitials can be presented on a timeline. A common use case when inserting ads with VOD content is marking the interstitials as a point on the transport bar. When playback reaches the point, the playhead stops as we play the interstitial. After interstitial ends, primary content resumes and the playhead proceeds onwards. Another use case with interstitials is representing the interstitials as a range in the transport bar, such that interstitial duration is included in the overall transport bar duration. This would be commonly used with ads and broadcast-style live streams, or anywhere you replace burned-in content with interstitials. This last example is an extension to the previous example. In the previous example, we clearly denoted the interstitial in the UI with a yellow highlight. In this case, the interstitial to be incorporated as indistinguishable from the primary content. This is useful when using HLS interstitials with rating bumpers, pre-rolls such as show recap, or post-rolls for dub cards, in particular for cases where the content is closely related to the primary content. Now that we've looked at the different cases that integrated timeline will model, let's learn the additions to AV Player Interstitial Event API for signaling each of these use cases. For signaling a point on the timeline, we can create an interstitial event and set a new property called timeline occupancy with the value as single point. This time, for signaling a range on the timeline, we can set the event's timeline occupancy to fill. However, since interstitial events are loaded dynamically as the playhead approaches, the actual duration of the event may be discovered late. We can provide a planned duration as a fallback for a timeline to use until the actual duration is known. It is best practice to set this property for range interstitials. For the final case, where the range interstitial should be indistinguishable in the UI, we can set supplement's primary content to true. Now that we've looked at how we can signal interstitial behavior on the timeline, let's look at Integrated Timeline API. For observing timeline progression, Integrated Timeline provides an API for obtaining the current time. When the playhead reaches the point event, current time stops progressing while the event plays. After the event finishes playing, current time progresses again, and in this case, when we reach the next interstitial event, current time continues to progress as we play the event. Integrated timeline also provides the ability to seek into an interstitial. Suppose the client would like to seek forward by 10 seconds. This would land in the middle of this fill event. Without this API, it would be difficult to accomplish the seek, in particular because the interstitial event is neither loaded nor enqueued on AV Player at this moment. However, this API makes it easy to accomplish seeking arbitrarily through any location on the timeline, irrespective of whether it's a main content or an interstitial. As part of integrated timeline, it vends out a new object called AV Player Item Segment. Each region of the timeline is a segment, where each segment provides key details about the content and time it occupies on the timeline. Even ranges of the primary content are considered as segments. One of the biggest benefits of the integrated timeline is that it makes it easy to draw your playback UI. But to do so can be difficult as the timeline is constantly changing. In order to provide a self-consistent state, we introduce a snapshot object, which the timeline can vend out. The snapshot represents an entire set of self-consistent properties that are needed to draw your UI. Now, as playback progresses and the timeline changes, the snapshot on the bottom stays static and does not mutate. With an AV Player Item integrated snapshot, we can obtain a list of all the AV Player Item segments in that snapshot. In this example, I pulled out a couple of segments so we can take a look at their values. For example, the first primary segment in the snapshot would mark itself as primary and occupy a range from 0 to 5 on the timeline. The next segment is the interstitial point event. Here, the segment indicates it occupies 5 to 5, a 0 duration. It will also provide access to the interstitial event, which would also contain its timeline occupancy as a single point. Lastly, the final segment selected is a fill event. This segment occupies 20 to 30 on the timeline, with a timeline occupancy of fill. Now that we understand all of the key objects, let's look at how we can build a simple UI with integrated timeline. We start off by creating our primary AV player item. We then obtain the integrated timeline from our AV player item. Now we can grab a snapshot from a timeline to draw the current state. Let's assume we have a routine to draw a UI slider that just needs a start, end, and current position. We can obtain all these values from the snapshot. Our start will be 0, our duration is simply the snapshot's duration, and the current position is the snapshot's current time. At this point, we have a simple transport bar that would include the fill interstitials as part of the overall slider. Now we want to start drawing single points in the timeline. In order to obtain the location for the point events, we can filter on the snapshot segment and only include segments that have a type of interstitial and a timeline occupancy of single point. Now for each of these segments, we will draw a point using the segment's time mapping target start as its position on the overall timeline. Lastly, let's highlight the fill interstitials. Here we will filter the snapshot segments and include segments representing interstitials with an occupancy of fill. Since supplement's primary content indicates that the event should not be distinguished in the UI, we ignore any interstitials with that set. Once we have the segments, we simply use the segment's time mapping, target, and highlight that region on the UI slider. The timeline can be very dynamic and can change often as interstitials get resolved or is frequently updating in the case of live streams. As such, it is necessary to listen to snapshots on the sync notification from the timeline to update our UI when this occurs. When the notification closure is called, we can examine the reason in the user info. For example, if the reason is segment has changed, we may want to redraw a transport bar using a new snapshot. However, when the reason is current segment change, we may want to update player controls or other UI elements if we're transitioning into an interstitial or out of one. Now that we've looked at the API and some sample code, let's look at an example app attached to this talk. In this sample app, we have included different examples. Let's take a look at an example called fill interstitial. The example includes a range interstitial scheduled at 10 seconds into the content. The transport bar at the bottom shows the interstitial with a yellow range starting at 10 seconds. As we play, playback transitions to the interstitial at the expected time. Now we can try some seeks and seek back into the primary content. Finally, we perform a seek back into the interstitial. Awesome! Earlier, I showed you how to construct interstitials in your app, but you can also specify them in your primary playlist. Here's how you can describe their appearance on the timeline from the server. Starting with the point example, here's a date range tag for an HLS interstitial. In order for the timeline to consider this a point, we have introduced a new attribute, xTimelineOccupies, with a value set as point. We also included a new attribute in the date range tag, X timeline style, with a value of highlight. This denotes that the client should mark this point in their UI presentation. For the range case, the new X timeline occupies attribute set with a value range. The X timeline style remains the same as the previous example. Lastly, for the case of presenting the interstitial indistinguishable in the UI, X timeline occupied remains as range. X timeline style is set to primary to indicate that the app's UI should not mark this uniquely. Since integrated timeline would allow for interstitials to be presented part of the primary content in the UI, it would make sense that these interstitials can also be coordinated during a SharePlay session. So this year, we're adding support for interstitials to be coordinated. Let's take a look at how interstitial SharePlay will work and how you can enable it. So here we have two players in the coordinated SharePlay session. The idea is that both player 1 and player 2 would continue to synchronize playback during playback of event 1. For seeks, suppose player 1 wants to seek out of event 1, back into the primary content. This seek will get proposed to player 2, and both players will continue to synchronize playback from this new point. One of the key requirements for enabling SharePlay support with interstitials is requiring the interstitial event to be common with all participants. In other words, event 1 in this example needs to be common for both players. It must be the same content. If the interstitials are not common, the player should not coordinate playback during the interstitials. Let's see how we can signal this requirement. One of the new additions to AV player interstitial event is a Boolean to specify whether content will vary across participants or playback sessions. In this example, saying content may vary to false will signal that this interstitial is static or common and allow this event to be coordinated. Lastly, we can also signal the same behavior on the date range tag using a new attribute X content may vary and setting that to no. Okay, let's now take a look at our sample app, which supports SharePlay. We have two phones set up in the FaceTime call. For this demo, we will choose the fill supplements primary example that includes an interstitial at 10 seconds in the content. Notice that both phones start in sync, and when we transition to the interstitial, they continue in sync. We then issue a pause, followed by a seek backwards, and lastly, we seek forward. Notice that all these commands work seamlessly with both devices. To wrap up, you can now use integrated timeline to build your UI experience with interstitials. You can customize the interstitial experience by specifying the behavior, either in the API or using the new date range attributes. You can now also enable SharePlay support for interstitial assets by marking the interstitial as not variable in the API. For additional related talks, please see Explore Dynamic Pre-rolls and Mid-rolls in HLS for learning more about HLS interstitials. For learning more about SharePlay, see Coordinate Media Experience with group activities. Thank you for watching.